Welcome to this presentation on an improved low-cost laptop. My name is Kannan Moudgalya. I'm from IIT Bombay. The outline of this presentation is as follows. We will present the motivation for a laptop. We will explain the features of a specific low-cost laptop. We will demonstrate its effectiveness and its shortcomings. We will then introduce a new laptop. We will compare old and new laptops. We will also explain how to buy the new laptop. Why do we need laptops? A tablet or a smartphone is a consumption device, whereas a laptop is a device for creators. 90% of our students have mobile phones, but only 10% of them have access to laptops. Access to a laptop improves job potential. For a successful Digital India and Make in India, we need to give them laptops. Here are the specs of a low-cost laptop. Here is its picture. We brought it in Ubuntu. It came with a lot of software. These are the most important requirements of the laptop. It should be good enough for the first year IIT Bombay BTech students for the first programming course so that we can study its efficacy. It met the programming needs, as you can see from this picture. It is also useful for other purposes. Here is a screenshot of a Hindi spoken tutorial viewed on Firefox. We did the pilot study twice for 55 BTech students in Jan 2015 semester. We repeated in July 2016 semester for 90 students. Studied the second pilot rigorously. Who used our low-cost laptops? 90 IIT Bombay first-year BTech students. Their annual parental income was less than rupees 2 lakh. Less than 30% fathers were graduates. Their mother's education was even less. Low income, less educated families. Here is the IEEE paper that came out of that rigorous study. We now present the summary. Why did we undertake this study? These students were already at a disadvantage. They came from less educated families and with low parental income and hence low motivation levels. Having to use a low-cost laptop could be seen by critics as a punishment. We wanted answers to the following questions. Do the 90 students like the low-cost laptop? How does this computer perform compared to normal, more expensive laptops? Our study is based on inputs from 90 students who used our low-cost laptops and 188 students who used their own more expensive laptops. We asked why they like to use our low-cost laptops. Their answers are given next. They did not want to waste time going to the computer lab, did not want to spend money in buying a computer, to work in privacy. Hostel computers were neither adequate nor available. We asked them why they liked our low-cost laptops. Their answers are given next. They were able to complete all tasks using this device. Low weight of the laptop. It improved their productivity. It came with many useful software. They could also install many useful software. They did not have to worry about any virus. Instant access to a computer helped test their ideas quickly. In summary, this laptop was easy to use and they would recommend it. Previous answers are based on the perception of 90 students. We now present answers based on actual performance. We present data on usage of low-cost laptops by 90 students. Let us focus on the last line. Only 2% of them wrote 1,000 lines or more before the course. This number increased to 57% after receiving our laptop. We conclude that the low-cost laptop was used extensively. We now compare the work done by users of expensive and low-cost laptops. Let us look at the last line once again. Only 23% of the expensive laptop users wrote more than 1,000 lines. The corresponding number for low-cost laptops is 57%. Students wrote more code on low-cost laptops. We now check the performance of low-scoring students in the course. We can see that 6% of the expensive computer users scored 0 to 20% marks, whereas only 2% of low-cost laptop users are in this bracket. We now compare the average marks of expensive and low-cost laptop users. Expensive laptop users scored 62.1%. The low-cost laptop users are close behind at 58.5%, not statistically significant. So, the overall performance is about the same. Now, we present the summary of answers to two questions that we asked earlier. Do the 90 students like the low-cost laptop? The answer is yes. How does this laptop perform? It performs very well. Do users of the low-cost laptop not like any feature? Yes. They don't like small RAM and small storage, unfriendly keyboard, and unfriendly trackpad. We wanted to overcome the shortcomings. We also wanted an Intel processor because a lot more Linux software runs on it. We have now come up with a laptop that meets the above requirements. The rest of this presentation about this new laptop. We now compare the old and new laptops. In the new laptop, the screen size is bigger. It has 4GB RAM. It has 32GB NAND flash. It even has an expansion slot in which one can add a hard drive. It has Intel Atom processor. It's a quad-core processor. It uses the popular micro SD card. It has 10,000 mAh battery, it has a graphic accelerator, the weight is slightly more, it is sleek, and the price is slightly higher. To summarize, the new low-cost laptop is at least twice as good as the old laptop at a slightly higher price. For example, the battery in the new laptop lasts at least 10 hours for normal usage. This new laptop runs on Debian Linux. A large number of software packages are installed in it. Here is a sample screenshot on the new laptop. You can see a 3D plot created by Scilab. You can also see the Blender software. It also comes with spoken tutorials for self-learning of the installed software. The video you are watching now is recorded on this new low-cost laptop. We now present testimonials on the new low-cost laptop by IIT Bombay experts. We request you to pause the video and read them. Here is the testimonial given by Professor Fatek. Here is the testimonial given by Professor Varsha Apte, the head of the computer center. Here is the testimonial given by Professor Sudarshan, the former head of the computer science department. The testimonial continues here. Professor Madhu Belur of electrical engineering says this. Professor Sachin Patkar of electrical engineering has given this testimonial. It is continued in the next page. This is what Professor Subramaniam of chemistry says. How does one buy this laptop? I will explain it next. Who can buy it? Any group that wants to buy a minimum of 300 laptops. It could be a university, college, or a school, or a group of colleges, schools, etc. Companies could buy it. Non-profit organizations could buy it. In fact, anybody could buy it. For their own members, support staff, etc., for their neighbors, friends, etc., there is absolutely no maximum limit. Why a minimum number of 300? In low-cost devices, after-sales support is a problem. There is not enough margin to provide a good service. Volume purchases make after-sales support possible. Groups can be better supported. Local support people can be trained. We now present different use cases, outright purchase by students, employees, etc. Institutions can also purchase and give them on rent to their students or staff, use them in classrooms, can be used for online exams also. We now explain the purchase procedure. The vendor will give a golden sample to IIT. The IIT team will test the laptop. If the laptop is found to be good, then will be shown to interested groups. Group representatives collect rupees 10,000 per laptop, forward rupees 2,000 to IIT or escrow account as the case may be. Vendor will make available laptops in a month. IIT team will check if identical to golden sample. If identical or better than golden sample, then the group should pay the balance rupees 8,000 within 2 days to the vendor and collect the laptops. If not paid within 2 days, the advance is forfeited. Else, that is, it is not as good as the golden sample, then the advance of rupees 2,000 is refunded to the groups. This comes with 1 year hardware warranty by the vendor. First year's annual maintenance cost is included in rupees 10,000. For subsequent 2 years, AMC is rupees 750 per year, including GST, available only if bought for the entire lot by a group. The OS and software support are from IIT Bombay. Upgrades to OS to be made available for at least 1 year. We will help train at least one person per organization that buys 300 units on the OS. Support through the website yanix.in, user forums, etc. This activity is supported by a project at IIT Bombay. If there is a consolidated order for a minimum of 5,000 laptops, this laptop can be assembled in India, will be entitled to a Made in India certificate. We already have a commitment for more than 4,000 units. We invite you to join us in this nation building initiative. Do you have comments or questions? We would like to hear from you. Please write to us at this email address. Thanks for joining. Goodbye and Jai Hind.